Namaste, I'm Vatsala Tyagi, a yoga devotee and a storyteller. Today I have a short story with a very important message. Hope you enjoy it. Once upon a time, there lived a king who had four queens. The fourth wife was the king's most favorite. He lavished her with expensive gifts, clothes, jewelry, her favorite food, all the luxuries and comforts imaginable. The king was also very proud and possessive about his third wife. He loved to show off this bold and beautiful queen to everyone. The king had deep affection for his second wife too. In fact, she was his go-to person in good or bad times. King's first wife was a very loyal partner who had made great contributions in his life, but he hardly took notice of her. Once, the king fell seriously ill and thought he was about to die. So he called his most favorite, the fourth wife, and asked her, "Darling, now that I'm about to die, will you follow me to afterlife to give me company?" "No way," said the fourth wife, and just walked off. Heartbroken, the king posed the same question to his second favorite, the third wife. But she just laughed out loud and said, "What a ridiculous idea, O king. In fact, I plan to remarry once you're gone." Shocked, the king asked the same question to his second wife. She was a little more receptive to the idea. She held his hand gently and whispered, "O king, I love you loads, but I can't accompany you. I'll ensure, though, that you get a grand funeral befitting a king." Just then, a soft voice called out, "O king, I'll come with you. I'll follow you wherever you go." The king looked up, and there was his first wife. All his life, he had showered all his affection and attention on these three wives who were so easily willing to part ways with him. But his neglected first wife was the only one standing by his side. But it was too late to correct his mistake, and the king could only regretfully think, "I wish I had taken much better care of her when I had the chance." In truth, metaphorically, we all have these four wives. Our fourth wife is a body. No matter how much time, effort, care, attention we lavish in making it look beautiful, it will eventually leave us. Our third wife is our wealth, our possessions, for which we work so hard, often at the cost of our health and even our relationships. But it will pass on to others once we are gone, just like the third wife remarrying. And a second wife represents our family and friends. No matter how much they love us, the maximum they can be with us is still a funeral. And a first wife is our soul, which we often neglect in the pursuit of power, wealth, and pleasures of the world. But it is a soul which will stay with us forever till eternity. So this year, let's invest on a well-being and growth, not just at the physical, mental, emotional, professional, social levels, but also, and more importantly, our spiritual well-being, to get connected to our soul, our true essence. And to nourish a soul is to cherish it and feed it with mindfulness, positive thinking, acts of kindness, and intentional self-care. I plan to share my experiences of the yogic concepts that I'm applying in my life and stories that inspire and motivate me. If content like this interests you, then do join me in this journey of self-discovery. Namaste.